Alright folks, welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy X on the Serious JG. This is not my first attempt to record this video. Never getting very far in, but a couple of little glitches popped up that I noticed. I stopped my video because I noticed something. Here is a little clip from the last video.
Nitrous, whatever it is that makes you laugh.
Listen, like two different levels of sound going at the same time, that's pretty funky. Here's Orin telling us that we'll hurt no one. You notice how there's this black space around the outside when you full screen it? Yeah, that's because of the size of the PCSX2 window that I had, and the size of the recording, and I never noticed that before. And nobody seemed to complain or say anything. And I've had a lot of people complaining about the video lag, and I posted an announcement that I don't think I could fix it. And viewership on this LP has already dropped off substantially. This thing is now doing slightly better than an SNES RPG, which makes me sad, but I'm going to play the game anyway because I like this game. I don't know if it's just the normal drop-off after the first video. A bunch of people tune in and then nobody wants to watch after that, or like it seems like I can get people who watch for two or three videos and then stop on almost anything I do. Or if it's because people are frustrated by the graphics, but yeah, I'm doing it full screen. I also played around with different settings, and maybe I'll change them up here and see if it makes a difference. You guys can tell me. But, I had to play with my graphics plugin settings and change it from software. It was on hardware. I changed it to software because for some reason I was trying to see if I would be able to record Final Fantasy X-2 or if I would have to do that on an actual PS2 when I get back to Konus. I don't expect to start Final Fantasy X-2 before I get back to Konus regardless, but I found out that using the latest plugin and the software render setting instead of hardware, there's some kind of glitch with Final Fantasy X2, where the game looks fine, but the cinematics, anything that's full CGI, looks weird and glitched out. There's like lines all over the screen and just weirdness, and you can fix that with the software setting. So I'm going to try the software setting on this game and see if it makes things look better. I doubt it will. I think the idea was that the hardware mode setting actually, I think, is better, but it software. It created some kind of glitches with Final Fantasy X2, but we'll see if it makes things any better in this game. Which we're going to get back to now. Now, the other thing I wanted to mention is I haven't played this game in a couple of weeks. I think we're on video 19 now. I think I'm recording video 19. Videos 1 through 18 I recorded within the span of about a week or so. Week or two. Two or three videos a night, a couple of nights in a row recording. You can get pretty far in this game. Because I'm in this situation now where I got more free time than I probably should have. I could be putting in some late hours on work, but, you know, sometimes I just don't want to, and because we're kind of on call 24/7, but as long as you get your work that's assigned to you done, it's, you know, I don't want to get into too many details in my work life, but I'm in a situation where I can LP, and pretty much the only thing I can do for fun. Maybe I'm into the LPing thing too much, but back in the States, if I was home on like a middle of the week, like a Tuesday or Wednesday night, well, Wednesday night's actually the night Bobo and I tended to get together, but, like a Tuesday night or a Monday night or something, or like I worked the whole day and I'm kind of tired, usually I wouldn't record, I would just watch other people's LPs. It's very difficult to do that here. I've been trying to keep up with Bobo, can't quite keep up with his videos right now, because my internet access kind of comes and goes, and recently I haven't really had the ability to watch videos much at all, or it's very difficult. It's like the first one I gave up on trying to watch. I had been watching some of Grimmoth's stuff from over here. Now it's gotten to the point where I really just can't. I'll watch his announcement videos, but not his LPs, which I have a weird feeling a lot of people do that. I don't know why you would watch his announcement videos if you don't routinely watch his LPs. But I'm just watching his announcement videos and intend to watch the LPs later. I've been trying to keep up with Bobo. It's been difficult. I usually can keep up with Steambot Chronicles, but I've been falling further and further behind with Let's Play Together, with or Let's Watch Red Play, the Dragoon, whatever, it's Legend of Dragoon, which is too bad because I've enjoyed that LP. I've been able to keep up with Zerfall, and I've been able to keep up with Nine Inch Nails 8 Halos. But if you go and look at their, you know, most recent videos, you'll be able to see why it hasn't been that challenging to keep up with them. Hi, guys. Really enjoy your videos, but they're not coming out in a fast and furious rate. Hey, maybe they actually have lives outside of this hobby. Who knows? But Zerfall had been posting pretty regularly, and it seems to have dropped off again recently. He's got quite a few LPs. It seems like he has a couple things he started, but they... other people, like LP togethers with people, and then if those people aren't available, he can't do it. But Eternal Felina, I don't know. By the time this is posted, he's probably will have finished Eternal Felina and three more RPGs, but... yeah, it's been a little while. And then the one that I really wanted to mention before I shut the F up and get on with the game here is that Shady Knights surprised me by, after I started this LP, Shady Knights has got three LPs going. He's got this Final Fantasy X, he's got Mass Effect, which I also intend to LP, and then he's got a third game, which I don't remember the name of, because that's the only LP he's doing that I haven't been watching, because I'm not familiar with the game, and I'm usually... watch LPs of games I already know, which is, you know, to some people it's really strange, but to me, I usually only watch an LP of a game if I already kind of know the game, or if it's an LP that I'm fond of. And I am fond of Shady Knights, but I didn't pick up his third LP at this point, in part because it appeared from the, just the, it was a JRPG, and it looked like it was probably really long, and Shady Knights comes out with one very good, very enjoyable video every couple of months. So I kind of didn't want to get into watching it until I'd seen him get a few recorded. But he's continuing on with all three, and he's posted new videos since I started recording this, which I honestly thought his, you know, he just, because of technical issues and other things, he had other stuff to do, and I really did think he was just not going to be able to LP anymore when I started this. It's one of the reasons I allowed myself to play this. It's like, well, you know, I thought about it before, and I really didn't have the technical capacity, and I was already watching somebody else's. But yeah, Shady Knights is now coming up with new videos, and I can't watch them because I'm in Afghanistan. So it's like, you know, I watched the first, like, third of a Final Fantasy X video, and he actually referenced me in it, but the computer crashed out. I haven't even been able to respond to him in a comment section or anything yet, so, oh well. That's about 7 minutes of just nonsense, so let's get back to it. That guy didn't say anything interesting. I talked to him during my first effort to start this, where I realized that we weren't going full screen. In the last video, I mentioned that we were going to try to get Titus in the front row so we could flee from battles we didn't care about. There's one problem there, because of the way that I leveled Titus up, where I dragged him back into the central area and grabbed some skills. He hasn't progressed as far along his path as he normally would, and he doesn't have flea yet. Now I have another save where I've been grinding, and oddly enough, Oren has flea, but Titus hasn't gotten it yet. So, yeah, that's weird. I think we'll eventually come to a point where I was leveling off screen with Titus, where Titus went, got some of Yuna's skills, just some basic healing magic, came over here and got, somehow, I forget exactly how the navigation worked, but he ended up getting into, I don't think there was any key spheres involved, but he got onto Riku's path. The beginning of Riku, so he got the beginning of Yuna's path, the beginning of Riku's path, and got dumped back onto his own path after the point at which he would get flea, and I didn't end up getting flea, so that's kind of silly. Well, we're just going to have to fight battles as quickly as we can then, because we can't actually... Well, I could individually make characters escape. Let me show you that, anyway. You're thinking, why is there a flea skill? Is that really the only way to run away from enemies?
Don't break any bones, old man.
Go to bed, old man! My patience has its limits. Now, flea is a skill. You go to special, and where he's got Cheer, Jinx, and Lancet, he'd normally have flea, which means automatically on that turn, the entire party flees battle. Can be used against pretty much anything except bosses, and I think Tonberries, you can't use it against them. I don't remember that for sure. With anyone else, you have to individually make them escape, and then the other... and you can fail, which I had not intended to showcase here, because I kind of forgotten you could. You turn around and just fall on your face like an idiot. This is also the screen where you change weapons, but and armor, but I almost never bother to do that during battle. See, Orange just seems to think the better of it. Lulu, however, gets the F out, no problem. Oh, come on, Orin. Don't stay behind and die. There you go. So as you can see, it's probably more trouble than it's worth. If I brought in Waka to take care of the flyers and my spell users, I would have won that battle faster by killing the enemies than I did by individually getting people to escape. So that's why the fleet command's important. That's why it kind of sucks that I don't have it. My bad. I wasn't thinking about that. Sorry. So, Luzu and Gata. Oh, I thought there was going to be dialogue here. And they run off faster than I'm allowed to, so I can't go talk to them about what's going on. This is pretty much the party that I would want for this fight, actually. Although Yuna actually has a higher magic score. Yuna's a better black mage in my other game, the one that we'll be loading when we get that far in the plot. Yuna's actually a more powerful black mage than Lulu is. Yeah, he said that last time too, and I wasn't a fan. I don't know at this point if Yuna has... Yeah, in this slot, she doesn't have any black magic, but, she was significantly more dangerous than Lulu in my other game. There are lots of fiends who say, stop, use this when the going gets tough. When the going gets tough, the tough get going, the going gets tough. Okay, I do have dialogue with them that is scooted off over to the side here. They're just constantly biting Lulu. I don't really understand that.
It's over.
Technically, Waka's supposed to be used against flyers, but there's no particular reason he can't be used against those guys, which are the only thing that Titus is supposed to specialize in, those little fast, coyote-looking enemies, so it kind of sucks for Titus.
Hey, we saw the game! You guys were great!
Congratulations, Waka.
It's probably slightly different if we don't win. But then again,
hey,
maybe not.
Stop loafing around.
The Lady Summoner and her guardians...
This mission requires our full attention. We've no time to waste.
No, Lady Summoner and her guardians. Lady Summoner here. They can talk to me.
Ma'am. Apologies, ma'am.
Yes, bitch. I mean, ma'am. Carry on talking to the Lady Summoner and her guardians, who are more important than you.
See, keep your head down, say sir a lot, and you'll do fine.
Right, sir.
I'm easily amused.
Even though Yevon rejected us, we still believe in you. That won't ever change.
I don't care. Yevon's rejected
you. Sir Luzu.
Sir Luzer. Boom.
But, you know, it's not too late for you to go back to Besaid and...
We should be going, sir.
So that's Yevon's strategy, huh? Super hot nuns trying to talk you into accepting the church. Baptists are not above that kind of thing. Cute chicks. I mean, obviously they're only one to go so far, but they're not above smiling at you. Freaking Baptists. Yes, I'm insulting Baptists for no reason. No, I do. I do have a personal experience I won't share with you of attractive Baptist females chatting people up and very kind of... You're like, are you guys sure that you're allowed to chat us up like this? I mean, you're Baptists. You're not going to... Okay, I just got done moving Orin away from Flea, so apparently I've decided Titus is going to be the one who gets that skill. And, Waka... I guess can grab one more stat boost thing before he starts back on his path, but... That was a cute little dialogue, though. I always talk over the dialogue in this game, or interject my own humor, but... I like that, Gaza telling, or Luzu telling Gaara, or Gaara telling Luzu, whichever one's which. The red-haired senior one telling the younger one, just keep your head down, say Sirla, and you'll be fine. I like that.
We'll defeat Sin any way we can.
Any which way but loose.
Yevon's teachings say...
Oh, shut up.
Enough!
I only meant to...
It's okay, Sasami.
Are you all right?
Or you can call it Tsunami.
Lady Summoner?
Blitzball victory for everyone!
I am Yuna. It is an honor, my lady.
Oh, shut up.
My name is Shalinda. I am a disciple of Yevon.
I'm preaching at these people about how they're bad.
The Crusaders operation?
You mean the one Gaara and Luzu were talking about?
Heathens!
Mm.
I heard they were to use forbidden machina. I had to stop them.
Hey, look. What a man does with his machina behind closed doors is none of your business.
Is strictly forbidden by the Yevon priesthood.
But what about the frickin'...
Bad, yeah?
Let them use whatever they want.
It's like a high-tech crazy blitzball sphere thing.
But... It's not about defeating Sin.
This whole game is about defeating Sin.
The teachings of Yevon must be upheld.
Yeah, right.
But you don't understand. The Crusaders won't even listen to me.
I'm not sure why we're listening to you.
It's all because I'm just a lowly acolyte.
You should hire the Acolyte Protection Agency.
Well, I haven't been a summoner for very long myself, you see.
Although I still outrank an acolyte.
I can't put myself down every time I fail.
I'd never stop.
People are depending on me. They're depending on both of us.
But mostly me.
Yes. Yes, you're right, my lady.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely.
She looks like she's really enjoying this conversation.
Thank you so much, Lady Yuna. Now, I feel I have the courage to finish my training.
Yeah, okay. We got to go defeat Sin now. Although, of course, it's not about defeating Sin.
I will do my best to get myself appointed to a temple as a nun. I will do my best.
You're awfully young to be throwing away the chance to be happy. Sorry.
Hey, I'm a guardian now, so watch out.
Bitches.
I mean, I shouldn't say that. There is obviously people who feel that the call to serve as nuns or monks or whatever at a very young age, but, I mean, you know, they don't even seem to have a god. They just have a church with no god, so... Who is it who's inspiring people to want to become nuns? Oh, that was a dumb idea. I forgot. This game, you only got 3 turns to kill them. Doesn't work the same in X2 and some other games. Like I said, I haven't played this for a while. A couple of weeks. Played a whole bunch, then took a little break. Oh, shoot, I can't use... I'm thinking of my other save where... Yuna has powerful black magic. Oh, this is gonna suck. This is gonna be a massive pain in the butt, actually. Okay, at least this thing's almost dead. And he's got, like, no, everybody who has useful skills has no mana left. Shouldn't really be that surprising. Let's power break on this a-hole. Love to use dark attack, but everybody who has dark attack has run out of magic by constantly using dark attack. Oh well, it's not like I can be liberal with potions, because, I can be liberal with items, too. None of this is going to matter. I'm just trying to fight through and show you guys the story and the game, and I'll come back later, and we'll have a much more advantageous position as far as levels and items. That being said, let's just get through this. I think at this point everybody except Yuna's done something. Suppose in theory I could get Yuna out here. I should, of course, consider having Yuna summon to kill this stuff quickly. Well, wait! I don't think she's summoned Ifrit yet. Let's let you guys check out the Ifrit summon. Why the heck not? Oh, I've got it on short mode. And apparently, if there's a special dialogue the first time she summons him, I either already saw it in this LP and forgot, or already saw it off-screen and have screwed us out of the chance to hear it. Okay, I'm bringing her over here to learn this stuff. That's what was going on the last time.
Some guardians, I'm using all my magic to keep you bozos alive. It's supposed to be protecting me.
Eye drops, that will make a huge difference in the battles ahead. Ah, Rin's travel agency, which I shouldn't recognize, but I've obviously played ahead.
But this is an outbed shop.
Is that a problem?
They don't believe in Yevon, and in Luca they...
So they
kidnap Yuna.
That's worth mentioning to Orin, I would say.
Guardians.
Ooh, burn!
Sir Orin's just concerned about your health.
I'm not tired one bit.
Well, I am.
Well, you're old. You're old. Enough said. Next caller. We've only actually traversed about 3 or 4 screens. Seriously, though, what the hell is that whistling about? I don't think I remembered that from previously.
As if I could sleep.
As if. You mean no memory card found? Yeah, I'm now an Albed Kibyagan. I'm now an Albed Sheboygan!
I've heard that the proprietor, Mr. Rin, is an Albed.
They're godless heathens.
I was very relieved to find that he keeps nothing sacrilegious here.
You annoy me.
I've heard that the but I was very relieved to find that he keeps...
He's a dirty wop, but he doesn't have any of those god-awful crucifixes with the Jesus on the cross here.
This might be the last time we can rest like this. This might be the last time we can rest like this.
If you don't know what a wop is, good for you. I think you're allowed to make fun of Italians now in the modern day. I mean, as long as there are not a lot of them around and they're not angry. Generally, white, ethnic groups from Western Europe you are allowed to make fun of. The Irish, for example. I'm not making fun of them, I'm just using an outdated slur for them as an example of why what she's saying is pretty awful. You guys already got it. Yeah, I don't want to talk to you, I want to talk to this dude here for some reason.
Mr. Rin's shops are all over Spira. They are quite convenient when you're on the road. Mr. Rin's shops are open.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna go off on the journey by myself then, if everyone else wants to hang around here at this sacrilegious owl bed shop.
Check it out.
Well, you know, topless over there? Oh.
That sunset was different from the one I saw in Killica.
That it back was different.
Quiet.
Oh.
Almost. Gentle.
What? You know, whatever. Time to pretend I care about sunsets. What's to impress Yuna.
I'm trying to have a moment of privacy?
Pretty.
Close your mouth.
Sure is.
I love the water.
I wish I could live in a place like this.
But Rin charges really high rent.
Peaceful. Living with a smile on my face every day.
Yeah, Besaid was a hellhole. full of war and conflict. Said, right?
Yeah, you're not really paying attention.
But then, a new sin will be born anyway.
Well, then you can just beat it again.
I'm always beating it.
I wish I could.
Hey, you can. Trust me. You are the best summoner out there.
You're better than Donna.
Yuna?
Which is the other summoner I met.
Come back?
Sin wants our ice cream bars.
Our punishment for our vanity. And it will not go away until we've atoned.
So he's punishment for the vanity twins. Perhaps punishment for Rick the Model March cell. No, no, he had Erogos.
It was so bad in the first place.
Well,
was it using lots of machina or something? Oh, wait, was that such a bad thing, really?
Your sins alone, Titus, will take much long to explain.
It's funny. Ever since I was young, I never questioned it.
Yeah, well, you don't really think for yourself much,
but
do
now
you?
You ask me if it is that bad or not. I don't know.
Weird shot a moment ago. I was distracted by looking up her sleeve and just how weird that looked.
Well, then we're the same.
No, you're not as... I'm not quite as dumb as you are.
Such thinking is very unbecoming of a summoner.
Why are you making fun of, like...
Sound like Micah?
Chinese people? Actually, no.
Stop doing your racist Chinaman voice. I don't really understand it.
I guess he kind of sounded like Micah. Just in the old guy sense. Anyway, you know, me Chinese, me play joke, me put pee-pee in your coke. Sound like Micah?
You know...
I like to make a lot of noise when I stretch.
During a game, you have to think of Blitz and nothing else, you know?
That's interesting. I was watching the sunrise. Sunset.
Nice answer.
You can't think... That's a cute girl in the fifth seat from the right. And you can't be thinking about where you're gonna go on that date, because the minute you do, that's when you lose.
So stop thinking about cute girls, or you'll never defeat Sin, Yuna.
You see, Yuna, what I mean is, you really shouldn't worry, you know?
Don't worry, be
After
happy.
After we beat Sin, that's when you can worry about the future.
I guess.
Do you okay? You're making this awkward, but I can't explain why without spoiling the story.
But Yuna, how are you supposed to beat something big like that?
We gotta kick in the nuts first.
The final summoning.
Oh. Or this final summoning.
It's the only way to defeat Sin. The only way. With it, we can call the final Aeon. That's the goal of the pilgrimage.
Which we explained to you earlier, actually.
The faith of the final summoning lies waiting in the far north.
Maybe we didn't.
To greet summoners that complete their pilgrimage.
He's always like, hey, how y'all doing?
At the world's edge. In Xanarkand.
Bit small victory, you clump of weeds.
In Xanarkand?
She means the ruins of a city destroyed 1,000 years ago.
Here comes the cock block. How long's he been listening?
You sure it's ruins?
That's what I've heard.
You'll see it for yourself soon enough.
Anyway, I'm here to tell you, don't think about the cute girl in the front row or you'll lose the Blitzball game. I just wanted to throw in my own advice there. I don't like that guy.
You will go with us to Xanarkand?
I guess so.
Yeah, I'll go.
Got nothing else going on. Yeah, she's thrilled at his reluctant acceptance.
To see it with my own eyes.
Another chance to chat up Yuna that went nowhere.
The over-the-top wind foley is nice.
I knew it couldn't be my Xanarkand, but I had to make sure.
Yep. Orin wanders in and stares at Titus when he sleeps, too. Trying to talk to Yuna, Orin wanders in. Trying to sleep, Orin wanders in. You're a guardian, right? I think this'll help. Hey, it's Key Sphere. Sphere model will teach you how to use it. Have you read the instructions yet? Oh, for God's sake. We've done enough tutorials in this game. I think I can explain this one without going through the official tutorial. You know how you activate spheres, ability, mana, power, whatever, whatever, whatever? Level 1 key spear, if you are adjacent to one of these, level 1 lock, you use that, it disappears, becomes an empty sphere. Point. So you would then be able to, like, if Yuna were up here, I could use that, this would go away. She'd then be able to move here and go up Riku's path, if she so desired. But that begs the question, what do you desire? There's a couple level 1s in the early part of the game. This one separating Tidus's path from part of Riku's. Although that's kind of a weird one, because it doesn't actually separate it from Riku's main path. You just come here onto this area, which isn't really on Riku's path, because you need a level 2 lock to get onto Riku's path proper. It's much more straightforward in the non-international version. This newer version kind of has a lot of stuff with this whole circle of stuff. If you actually stop and look at the paths, you come up here and you go down here and blah 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 blah. You don't get on this part. This part is actually a completely separate path, but they look like they're grouped together because of the round background-y shape. There's a lot less of that in the first game. First game, pretty much, you come onto this thing, you make your way around in different swirly patterns, and eventually you get dropped off on the other side somewhere. But no, the point was, level 1 key spheres open level 1 locks. Level 1 locks are these blocks that you can't get through, and that would prevent you from going from here to here, 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 here. With that level 1 key, you can do that. There's 4 different levels. Fortunately, getting 2 level 1 key spheres, you cannot combine them into a level 2. Which means that because of glitches, or not glitches, but weirdness with how you obtain them, some of them are like rare steals. I don't think any of the key spheres are actually rare steals, but you can get them through the bribe command. I remember playing the game and at one point having more level 4 key spheres than I could need. Like, I could open every level 4 lock on the grid and still have level 4s left over, but not having enough level 3s. But roughly speaking, 1s are the easiest to get, 4s are the hardest to get.
Bintasa.
Bandu me?
Sorry? Forgive me, sir.
Forgive on this, please!
Do say pardon me, but it came out in El Bed.
Watashi wa Nihongo no hanashimasen. Anyway, I called a video here. When we come back, we get to talk to Rin, who's a character. And we get to talk to him. It's gonna be pretty sweet. We pop this up as this will be my little indication that it's time to split the video. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video, folks. When we come back, we're gonna talk to Rin, the proprietor of the Albed shop, and the old dude whose name I can't remember now, the old scholar guy, explains to us there are several of these shops all over Spira, and Machin, is that his name? But anyway, the Rin doesn't pop up personally in all of them, but in theory, all of these little shops that pop up that are run by Albeds selling his stuff in unlikely locations are supposed to be part of his, like, chain. It's like the Quickie Mart. The Circle K of Spira is the Rin Travel Shop. But there's something afoot at the Circle K, there's something amiss, and we're going to find out what next time. Actually, there's nothing amiss in this. Although in Final Fantasy X2, there's a mystery that you have to investigate at the Albed shop, and it's fascinating. But we'll get to that in a future LP, and we'll get to this video and the conversation with Rin next time in this LP. Thank you for watching, folks. Mysterious JG here, signing off. Bye-bye.